Hi, my name is Samir Gupta, Marketing Manager for Intersil Corporation. Today, I am joined by Chance Dunlop, Director of Infrastructure Power. Hi, Chance. Thanks for joining.
Thanks very much for your time, Samir.
So, Chance, Intersil has a very rich history when it comes to digital power, having developed a wide range of products from digital point of load to multi-phase controllers. Could you tell us a little bit about latest generation multi-phase controllers that we just launched?
Absolutely. So today we're launching 12 new multi-phase controllers. This is our first digital multi-phase controller with a smart power stage. So it's a complete solution to address the need of any core processor in the marketplace.
That's great. 12 controllers, that's a pretty wide portfolio. So are there specific markets that we are looking to address here?
Absolutely. The 12 products actually span a wide range and unique application solution. Whether it's in the data center with an x86 processor or ARM-based processors, all the way through FPGAs and graphic processors. So anything in the marketplace, whether it's telecom, datacom, or data center, we can address those high current needs with this multi-phase solution.
Now, along those lines with multi-phase solutions, can you comment on what product variations we are launching in the market?
Absolutely. The family makes up a couple of different ranges, whether it's the x86, Intel-based, ARM-based, or we even have what's a general purpose using AVSBus solutions.
What's the real purpose of multi-phase controllers?
Multi-phase is used when you need really high currents. So typically we're running from a 12-volt input to those low voltage outputs, 1 volt, 0.9 volts. And you really want to have 300, 400 amps high current levels. Multiphase achieves this by splitting up the current into individual phases to balance itself from a thermal standpoint, give you better transient response and smaller size.
That's a lot of current. So why not drive all that current on a single phase?
The problem with using one phase is you get really large inductor, your FETs start becoming oversized. So overall, you end up with a lower efficiency, larger solution space, and more expensive solution. So from a best performance, it's actually better to have everything split up into different phases.
Now, earlier, Chance, you mentioned about driving as much as 450 amp currents. Why not just stack multiple controllers in parallel?
So that's one approach where people have tried, which is putting different controllers in parallel and try and drive to one common output. The problem is with these modern processors, as you're doing 450 amps, you're also doing transient slew rates of 1,000 amps per microsecond. If you try to drive it in parallel, they become out of balance. One device tries to source 200 amps, the other one tries to sync 200 amps. They fight each other. So the idea is you have one controller that drives all these phases together such that they're all balanced and in tune.
So 1,000 amps per microsecond is really fast. So how do you accomplish that?
So that's the advantage of digital multiphase. We use a patented control scheme that we call synthetic current control. We actively manage the current in each phase, cycle by cycle. So with any slew rate, we make sure every inductor, every phase is balanced perfectly and does not overshoot or ring, such that we can deliver the current when and where it's needed.
So everybody in the industry uses voltage control today. So why are you able to use current control?
Historically, no one uses current control because the problem is the noise. You have these really small duty cycles as you convert to these low output voltages. To be able to measure the current accurately in a noisy environment is extremely difficult. So even though it's the best control scheme, it's not practical. But this is where digital is able to overcome those analog limitations. We use a technique called synthetic current control. We actually synthesize every current waveform internally in the chip. So we get an accurate cycle-by-cycle waveform that has the full bandwidth, noise-free, and zero latency.
Zero latency, how's that possible?
Well, there's always latency and propagation delay as you move through the loop, for instance, going through the smart power stage. But what our device does is, because we control the synthetic current waveforms, we control the PWM clock, we can account for those delays. So overall in our loop, by having a predictive nature in our device, we can actually make sure that we have zero latency overall in the control waveform. And this gives us very precise current positioning.
So when you say predictive, what does that translate to when it comes to transient response?
Well, the advantage of this loop then is zero latency, very fast transient response. Now, the benefit of that is we can use less capacitance than any other solution in the marketplace. So for these high current rails, it's not uncommon to see 30% less capacitance, translating into a smaller solution and lower BOM cost.
So that's really a breakthrough product. Now, you mentioned smart power stage earlier. Can you tell us more about the power stage that we released in the launch?
Absolutely. We released the ISL 99227, which is a 60 amp smart power stage. Now, what that means is traditionally with multiphase controllers, you had external drivers and discrete MOSFETs. A power stage integrates all of those. What makes it smart is the fact that we now have current sensing and temperature sensing. So when you used to have to measure a DCR in your inductor to get your current information, we now have a differential signal going back to our controller that's accurately calibrated over line, load, and temperature, so we always know exactly the current per phase.
In other words, what you're saying is it eliminates complex DCR networks and simplifies the design.
Absolutely. You eliminate those RC components around the DCR, you've eliminated the mismatch in any of the errors that's introduced, and you've even removed one of those biggest noise sources. That phase note no longer couples in directly to that current waveform.
Thank you for the overview. In our next video, we will show you the evaluation board and Power Navigator software.